Allah, protectors of the Sunnah, protector of the Sunnah.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. To sit here is bitter. إن شاء الله بإذن الله سوف نتكلم عن أعظم رجل في الحياة. We're going to speak about the most great man in our life. يعني لن نتكلم عن السيرة. We're not going to speak of the سيرة. ولكن هناك مقتطفات من السيرة. Some of the سيرة. In fact, before we start this, actually, I was teaching فقه السنة. فقه السيرة. The book of فقه السيرة. The fiqh of the seer of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam before the Islam until he died sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Of course, that's a long time, but take from that fiqh al-seera, I take some speak together, inshallah, arba'in. We start, in fact, as we know, the Islam start when before Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam born. The Islam, people, as we know, worshipping idols. Worshipping idols. In fact, the idols before the idols, they worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Mecca, before the Islam, before even the Quraysh came to Medina, when the time of Ismail alayhi salam, Ismail alayhi salam, and who with Ismail? Hajar, and who? And Ibrahim. Are you okay, guys? Ibrahim alayhi salam came to Mecca, and Hajar alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam. Mecca, by the way, in that time, until now, by the way, igneous rocks. As we know in history, we have three types of rocks, that and one of the sukhur. We have igneous rocks, and metamorphic rocks, and sedimentary rocks. By the way, my PhD, the first PhD in geology. So this rocks is my life. So the igneous rocks, there is no way to have water. No water. Igneous rocks, only rocks from volcanic eruption. Metamorphic rocks as well. Metamorphic rocks, actually, another volcanic eruption, rocks over rocks. That means there is no sedimentary rocks to have water. Okay? And then, but everything, as we know and believe as a Muslim, everything in the plans of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كله بأمر الله سبحانه وتعالى. Of course, جرهم with Yemen. Yemen, by the way, Yemen is a war and war and war. But used to be the most rich country in the whole Arabia, Yemen. Those also called Sad Ma'rib, the dam of Ma'rib. Ma'rib until now called Ma'rib in Yemen. That water, the water completely demolished. The whole city demolished to migrate. Migrate, of course, used to be in that time Jewish and Christian. Jewish and Christian. And people not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well. So when the dam Ma'rib completely demolished, they migrate. Some of them went to Palestine, to Syria, here, to Egypt, different country. Okay? And then something with the world, with those people, the Jurhum, came to Mecca, and they know for sure in that area there's absolutely no water. There's no water. And they found water there. They found birds and water there. But of course, when they found there, Hajar there, Hajar alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam only. And how is and Hajar and Ismail, when you know the story, of course, I'm making summary. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order Ibrahim عليه السلام to take Hajar عليه السلام and Ismail to where? From Palestine, من liberate Palestine, to Mecca. Of course, an order, and he thought it's a dream, because he's a baby. And Rasulullah, Ibrahim عليه السلام, he became the baby 90 years old, 90 سنة. But still, by the order of Allah, take Hajar عليه السلام and Ismail where? In a desert. And what did she have? Some water and some dates. كله بأمر الله. And of course, I make a summary. Of course, Ibrahim عليه السلام, he left and Hajar in Samaria. يا إبراهيم إلى من تترك leave us for whom? إبراهيم عليه السلام no reply. One, two, three times. They are in الصفا area. We go to عمرة. Say, الله أمرك بذلك. Did Allah order you? إبراهيم عليه السلام قال بلى. No question. قالت إذن لن يضيعنا. Allah will never leave us alone. But إبراهيم he made the دعاء. We're speaking of future more دعاء إن شاء الله. مجد دعاء واجعل أفئدة من الناس تهوي إليهم. Now look at this masjid here. Many many nationalities. Why we are here? Yusuf, why we are here? Because Muslims, الحمد لله, right? وهذا من فضل الله سبحانه وتعالى. Now let's go to Ibrahim عليه السلام, محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Of course, Mecca start and start and start. Again, there are Muslims at that time, especially Ismail عليه السلام. And Ibrahim عليه السلام Muslims Mecca of course start step by step they take the idols from where? From the area of Palestine and Syria in that time to Mecca and رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم then in fact of course ألم ترى كيف فعل ربك بأصحابي الفيل Continue, read, I want the kids. أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِأَصْحَابِ الْفِيلِ The kids. Come on. أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِأَصْحَابِ الْفِيلِ كَيْدَهُمْ في وجعل وأرسل عليهم ترميهم So this surah actually came of course used to be Ibrahim عليه السلام Ibrahim عليه السلام rebuild the Kaaba قواعد إبراهيم who the one built the Kaaba first Who's the first one built the Kaaba? No. Adam عليه السلام. Adam عليه السلام. Then they rebuild the Kaaba again. Rebuild the Kaaba. Of course, many, many stories. But then when this happened, when Abraha al-Habashi came from Yemen to destroy the Kaaba, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala They destroyed them completely by that birth to Allah to protect the Kaaba. To protect the Kaaba. In that time, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam born. What the date of Rasulullah born? He born in Rabi' al-Awwal. But what day? Allah knows best. Not some people did. By the way, 19, some people 12, some people this. But we don't know how, what time. We know he في عام الفيل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم born in عام الفيل. Some people not our masjid. Some people celebrate that day, make a birthday of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Just like the Christian do it with عيسى عليه السلام. Until عيسى عليه السلام, by the way, in فلسطين عيسى عليه السلام in the Christian believe January 15 in Palestine. Here 25th, right? And actually, and in Germany, 22nd, and so on. But still, we don't mind when Rasul, we born here, he born, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, in the time of Al-Fiqh. Okay, now. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of course, his life from the moment he born struggle. We know Rasulullah, Abdullah, the father of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he married Amina radiallahu anha, Amina, before the Islam. And then after he got married, he went straight to make tijara, business, all the way to Palestine, to Sham, actually. When I say Sham, Sham, Syria, Palestine, Lebanon, and Jordan. Sham, Palestine, and Syria, and Lebanon, and Jordan is one country used to be. One country, I'm not going to speak the history, how it become like four countries, but use one country. Okay, it's a business in that time. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of course he grew in, and then when his father, 4 months in a, Mary Amina, as we know, of course in the story, and he died almost 2 ways by Medina, almost. He died there. And he become orphan. Why? When the father die, he become orphan, yatim. But still, Rasulullah, who took care of him after that? His father died. The grandfather, Abdul Muttalib, the one, Abdul Muttalib. But my point, he became orphan in that time. But his grandfather, of course, the kufr there, disbelief, he adopted him, his son, of course. He is the one give him the name Muhammad. He gave him Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. According to somebody gone, and then after that, he always took care of him. And who the chief of Mecca at that time, controlling Mecca, al-Kaaba, the grandfather. Of course, they have a place for him, the chief. In our country, we call it Mukhtar. In Egypt, we call it Umda. In Maghrib, we call it what? Not king, of course. For the tribe of Mecca, we had, but imagine no one allowed. No, give me attention here. When he was 6 years old here, he's a born, he's a baby. Not allowed anybody to stand in that place except Rasulullah. And he said, Da'u, فَإِنَّ لَهُ شَأْنًا. The grandfather said, leave him, he have something about him. Now, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of course, I make, by the way, I summarize what we learn in university in very, very summary. It takes time actually to summarize it, but to try as much as I can, inshallah. My point, brother, here, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he born with Amina, in Mecca used to be, as we know in history, very corrupted country. Number one. Number two, until now, travelers all over the people. You know, Hajj and Umrah, all nationalities, all colors. So it's a business area. In fact, when you go, Hajj, even now, the business, too much. There is no time, even hotels, you cannot even live, have a comfortable place in that place. So in their culture, when the baby born, go away from Medina to teach him to be strong. And he went with Hamza, his uncle, in that time born. Went to who? To Bani Sa'idah. Bani Sa'idah, tribe of Sa'idah. They were Halim al-Sa'diyah. Halim al-Sa'diyah. But again, Allah Azza wa Jal, يعني رتب ترتيب إلهي عن حياة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. He prepared Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم to be a leader. بني ساعدة في إن شاء الله we have a tour over there. Number one, they are good fighters. And they respect and honor and dignity there. In that time, there is no liquor. In Mecca, there is a lot of liquor. There is no zina. There is zina, the adultery, many bad things and liquor that in Mecca. but not in Bani Sa'idah. And Halim al-Sa'di, when she adopted him to breastfeed him with his brother, of course, her son. So many blessings come to Bani Sa'idah because of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She take care of him. They become beautiful stories, but and a summary, One of the things when she carry Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just born. Yes, he born. That donkey, very sick and hungry. And actually the whole Sa'idah, Bani Sa'idah, that tribe, is dry. When the mood he was with his mom, Halima Sa'diya, on that donkey, the donkey was running and running and running. Everybody wonder, well, look at that donkey is sick now, wrong. And he grew up there. What he learned first, Rasulullah, when he arrived Bani Sa'idah? Ra'i, a shepherd, take care of the animals. May Allah give rahmah to my father. I try actually when I grow up, I was just like you guys, active, so active, karate and this and that. I try to control the sheep. It's not easy, by the way. Very hard. To be a shepherd with a sheep. Number one, a lot of sheep and camels and horses and all kind of animals. And imagine a person controlling all this. That means that person, a special person. Number one, sabr. Allah teaching Rasulullah when he born. Sabr is number one. By the way, sabr is number one to have a safe life, a sabr. Allah yuhib, Allah love those people who have sabr. Sometimes we get angry. Rasulullah said, you get angry, yes. But only Rasulullah, if something, I speak about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not about him. He never defend himself. Now we defend Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because we know Rasulullah. But when somebody about Allah, he defend that. Otherwise, let it go. But he grew up with Halima al-Sa'diya. He, number one, he became a shepherd. Shepherd, many, many things to be a shepherd. And not only to control animals. To control animals and suffer. And what? You are in a desert. What? And not only all our animals, around him. And some food. That Allah planned for Rasulullah to be a prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay. Of course, when he become 4 years old, of course, after 1 year, of course, she go to Mecca, she have love for Rasulullah. When we speak, until now, when we speak about Rasulullah, what we said? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Immediate, right? Our wife, we love Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's true. Imagine, she breastfeed him. She feed him, she take care of him. It's more love. When you go to his mom, no, I still have to take care of him. I will do this. I will do it until he become 4 years old. 4 years old in Bani Sa'idah. Now, he's playing with his, of course, he's a kid. He's playing with his brother and everybody in Al-Hay. Al-Hay, the people in Bani Sa'idah, the tribe of Bani Sa'idah. Suddenly, two men, white clothes, came to the earth. From coming down, and the kids watching that, and they came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and not only that, وَطَرَحُوهُ أَرْضًا, they put down, and he opened his heart, his chest. Rasulullah said, he taught us, and whoever grew up when Rasulullah they spoke about that, and even Anas ibn Malik, والله إني أرى الشق في صدر رسول الله. I saw the line of Rasulullah with that place, the area. Allah take his heart and clean from Zamzam. Clean his heart from Zamzam. Oh, now Zamzam. Why we call the Zamzam? Why you say Zamzam? When you drink, you make Umrah and Hajj? Yeah. Why we call Zamzam? Why we call Zamzam? Do you know? No, I'm oh, you. I'm talking to you. Yeah. Do you know why you call Zamzam?
I'm just asking to translate.
Okay. When Hajar alayhi salam, Hajar alayhi salam, you know, Safa and Marwa. Safa and Marwa. How many times you go between Safa and Marwa?
Seven
times. Now, when Ibrahim alayhi salam left, and he made dua in the Safa. Safa, he made the dua. Allah maj'al afdalna. And then the food finished, the water finished, and the baby cry. What happened? She was running between Safa and Marwa, back and forth. If you go to Safa, you walk, and then depression a little bit. You run. Why? Because she cannot see her son. She run until Safa. Marwa, Safa. And suddenly, saw a sound. What is the sound here? And she saw people with Ismail alayhi salam. She left him there. And she ran straight. And Jibreel alayhi salam struck under the feet of Ismail alayhi salam. Under the feet of Ismail alayhi salam, the water came up. And then when she saw the water, what she did? Holding the water, zim. That we call Zam. Got it now? Not you, him. Got it? Zim, because Zim, that means try to hold the water. That was Rasulullah said, if Hajar lift the water, the whole Mecca will be a river, water. Water. By the way, that special water and that special rocks, I make research myself with that. I know the water very well. And even that water, the classification of crack and the chemical structure for that water is completely different. The water we drink right now, completely different. Of course, different type of agricultural chemical we can research with that. But believe it or not, and not only that, and also sahi, there is no germs in that water. Subhanallah. But that's in our job. That anyway, Rasulullah that's the reason. But Hajar alayhi salam, and then Rasulullah, when Sayyid Halima Sa'diya show Rasulullah, two men came, white men, white clothes, they take care of Rasul, وطرحوه أرضا in the ground. She was worried about the baby, not her son. Still the son by breastfeeding. She went back straight to Halima. Say, here, take your son, because I say, why? She asked why. She was afraid to say why. Kind of khayfa. And then she told the truth, honestly. I saw people came to death for them. I say, khufti alayhi min shaitan. Are you afraid for him, shaitan? Wallahi la yukhzi ibni abada. To do nothing, Shaitan will never touch my son. In fact, when the angel shaqqu sadr Rasulullah, when they open the chest of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they take the Shaitan from him. That's me. What about me? Do we have a Shaitan? Yes. We have two angels here, right? Guess what? We have two Shaitan too. We have Shaitan too. But Allah prepared Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for us. That's why if when you name Muhammad, be proud of yourself, Muhammad. Okay, all right. Okay, here, brother. Now, of course, Amina, the mom, she loved her son so much. Every mom, she loved by way. She loved her son more even the father. You feel sometimes your mom worry about you. I'm going to call the kids, mashallah, we have a lot of kids. Kids, I think your mom more. That's why Allah ordered us, the Rasulullah, your ummak, thumma ummak, thumma ummak, thumma badir abuk. Your mom, and then your dad. You do that, Muhammad? Alhamdulillah. Anyway. Now Rasulullah again, when he becomes 6 years old with his mom, His grandfather took care of him and 6 years old. And she, because his mom, her brothers in Medina, in that time called Yathrib, was up, okay? So when we went in Medina, she went to visit her family. She stayed 1 month in Medina Munawwara. With whom? With Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So a culture, now Mecca culture, Bani Sa'id culture, in Medina, then in Medina culture. This culture, by the way, until now, if you go to Mecca and Medina, is different even mentality of the people over there. And then what happened? They finish 1 month, she have to go back home. In the area called Al-Abwa, منطقة الأبواء, she died over there. Of course, the slave, her servant, the one took care of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم with him. And 6 years old, ست سنوات, دفن أمه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. 6 years, they buried Rasulullah, his own mom. Father and mom and 6 years old. Imagine how much Rasulullah start Allah Azza wa Jal preparing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be that person. Strong man. Strong man. Even Bani Sa'ida train him to be a man. A baby become a man. Or Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But anyway, when he came back to Mecca, who took care of him again? The grandfather. And he held him more now. But he died. The grandfather died. But this is very important, brothers, here. It's my advice. Hadith Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لا يبيتن أحدكم إلا وصيته مكتوبة تحت رأسه. No one should sleep without his own will, the wasiyya, written under his pillow, written. Especially we are in America. When I came here, actually, we spoke about it. My advice, you never know our life, something happened to me. You never know. My advice, that's why the wasiyya is very important. He made wasiyya, Abd al-Muttalib, the grandfather, to say Abu Talib, his son, to take care of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the time older, I have 12 uncles. But the grandfather chose him. Why? Number one, yes, he was not rich, but he's a wise how to deal with his kids. And he knew Muhammad, Abu Talib, he would take care of his own brother's son, his son, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He knew very well. He chose him. And because he make wasiyya, everybody accept wasiyya. Wasabi Rasulullah, the jinn, the grandfather, to the uncle, and he take care of him. Take care of him. But Abu Talib, by the way, had 12 kids also, plus daughters. By the way, he have one wife also. Okay. Imagine Rasulullah was among those kids because the father loved him, respect him. That's why, see, and he grew up with them. But he grew up an orphan, but start to work with them when he was 7 years old. He was also rai with them, shepherd with them, okay, with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also, and also, still he, the uncle, Al-Am, he was in charge. And suddenly, look at the plan here. Suddenly, the history, they make in for, okay, now, it will go straight again. They have a dry season at that time. There is no water. Become, there is no one even come to Mecca. There is no water at all. They ask the uncle, Abu Talib, to make dua in Mecca for the water. And the uncle, just like the grandfather, always Muhammad with him, Muhammad with him, Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. and both of them أسند ظهره إلى الكعبة. Both of them do it against الكعبة with رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم to make دعاء for the water to come down. And رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم he made the دعاء. The water came to Mecca. But in the same time that Mecca become a lot of water came. What happened here? The water destroyed the Kaaba. Destroyed the Kaaba. But now that Gidana rebuilt the Kaaba. When rebuilt the Kaaba. By the way, the Kaaba used to be just like this table, like this. The Kaaba used to be like this. Used to be. But the people of Quraysh, remember I said in the beginning, like liquor, adultery, corruption, and all kinds of bad things. But no, the Kaaba has to be pure money to rebuild the Kaaba. Pure. And with the money, they make it the size, what right now you see the Kaaba like a square like this, that is the size right now, used to be. But before that, you get bigger, that's this table here, like this. But only pure money. But of course, how many, we have it, like 12 tribes in Mecca, tribes. And they were put the black stone, Hajar al-Aswad, in that place, fighting. They want to kill each other. Astaghfirullah, four tribes. They want to put everybody, us. And then, no, we have a let's see. The first one entered the Kaaba, he let him place the black stone. Waiting for who? Enter. We know the story. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So I was planning that. When Rasulullah came, yes, ya Muhammad, and his name was the nickname? As-Sadiq. الأمين the truthful one صلى الله عليه وسلم and then the صادق الأمين you are the one what see he take his coat the عباية and put the rock there put the rock here and how much even before Islam he was very intelligent ذكي صلى الله عليه وسلم intelligent the black stone in the middle here. And the four tribes, they carry with a rope. And every tribe carry. They are united. And then Rasulullah take the black stone and place it himself. This is the plan for Rasulullah to be a prophet. See, sallallahu alayhi. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala nabiyyil Muhammad. Okay. Now, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also, when he was 12 years old, 12 sana, he grew up with whom? Again, remind me, he grew up with Abu Talib, his uncle. And he went now to go to Sham. Sham, as I said, Palestine, Syria, Lebanon, Jordan, that area, business. And also the Roman Empire, the Roman Empire was huge. So in the surah about غلبت الروم في الأرض وما بعد غلبهم, beautiful. We can speak about it later, inshallah. But my point, before he arrived Palestine, why Palestine? Where Palestine? Because the Jews were controlling Palestine that time. Actually, the Roman, but the Jewish, the way, until now, the Jewish always controlling the Roman in that time to for the Masjid al-Aqsa. And who saying, we know the story, Buhayra al-Abid, the Christian have a monk. And suddenly that monk, no one can see him. He always worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Worshipping, by the way, the real Bible, the true Bible, he is to worship. The real Bible there, and then immediately he went to, and he watched. That means even when that tribe, Abu Talib, and Rasulullah and the people with him with Quraysh traveling, they saw that real shajar, يقول لهم the trees about them and they sit together and all the trees like shade and بحيرة العابد that بحيرة the monk he invite them to eat and said did you left anybody behind you? I said no except a child. I said I want to see the child and بحيرة العابد that the monk came around رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم among رسول الله. I say من هذا يعني هذا من أبوه؟ Who's his father? The uncle said me. I say ليس أنت. His father supposed to be a dead person. Oh, that means the Bible? Yes, the Bible. See, the father supposed to be die. He's not alive. See, yes, his father. I am his uncle. And he say I want to see his neck. He want to see his neck. And he say a stamp in the middle of his neck. This is the children, you have to know that the children. And the stamp. A stamp. When he saw the stamp, and he told him, this this boy, he going to be a Nabi Hadi al-Umma. He's a prophet of this Ummah. Do not let him go into Palestine. If he enter, the Jews will kill him. He will kill him. Of course, immediately take another a person, take my stepson, my son, take him back to Mecca. And he never enter at 12 years old. That means, by the way, my second language, by the way, Hebrew. I speak Hebrew, it's my second language. I was born in Gaza Strip. So we have, under occupation, we have to learn the language. Muhammad Ahmed, actually, is in the Torah. In the Torah. So the Jews knows about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In fact, when Rasulullah, be your attention, I missed that. When Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam born, the people Habr Israel, the Medina, they all watching the sky, and then he saw a star shining. When he born that star, he told his wife. The Jewish in that time in the temple, I say, the Nabi هذه الأمة ولد الآن. He is born today. He born. I mean the Jews, لقوا نظر إلى 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 السماء the stars. ثم رأوا كوكبا a star a planet. I say that now we have a new a prophet of this Ummah. Find out. They thought in the beginning واحد منهم. One of them. Subhanallah, they know about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Muhayra, he know Rasulullah, and he told he's هذه النبي هذه الأمة. So my point here, brother, inshallah. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he grew up in Medina. 12 years, he went back to Rasulullah. He still shivered, and one day he was. With still shepherd, Rai Ghanam. He was with his companion, his partner. And one night he said, I heard like a music, Taranim in Mecca. I heard Taranim in Mecca. I have to go to Mecca to join myself at night time. And stay here because that person, he went there. And when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, before he enter, Allah Azza wa Jalla make him sleep. He slept until sunshine, second day. And of course, and he asked, what's going on? I said, a person, a man, somebody getting married. Of course, the music and this and that, but he never see or join that. He went back, and then, after that, another married, he heard another voices. He went also, he told his partner also, go and enjoy myself with him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the hadith of Bukhari, make him sleep before he enter Mecca. قبل أن يدخل مكة. صلى الله عليه وسلم. سبحان الله. ثم بعد ذلك قال, and then he said, والله لن أعود إلى ذلك أبدا. I will never go back. That's it. Allah planning Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay, And also Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he become also also 12 years old, 20 years old, one war happened between Harb al-Fujar, people tried to attack Mecca. He was 20 years, 20 سنة Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was making the nibl wal hal, ايش النبل؟ the spear with the هذا when you have an arrow, the spear, he was doing that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. He didn't fight, but he preparing the weapon for them in that time. That is Hujar. And other one, immediately about حلف الفضول. Okay, in that Mecca, of course, some people leaders and some people less. So there's no justice. But some certain people in Mecca, righteous people, I say no. When the Hajj come, the time to go. By the way, Hajj now, and the time now used to be a certain time, Hajj, Dhul Hijjah, used to mean until now, by the way, until now. See, if the people come, they steal their money, they are not just with the others. And group of tribes, young guys, Rasulullah was one of them. See, let's protect whoever come make Hajj to protect those people. And become like a leader, whoever come, safe. When he was in Mecca, قال رسولullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, والله if this حلف الفضول now, the حلف الفضول, the tribe of الفضول, I'll be part of them. Why? Because they are just, they are fair. Of course, رسولullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, رحمة. Don't forget, رحمة للعالمين. He's a رحمة, mercy for all mankind. All mankind. Okay? Then now Rasulullah become 25 years old. We're gonna finish inshallah after that. 25 years old. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who heard about Rasulullah? Khadija. Khadija. And this is very important daughter. Khadija, Rasulullah 25, and Khadija 40 years, 40 سنة. And Rasulullah 25, 25 years. And she was married before Khadija. Married before. And she went then, she heard somebody to take care of her business. She's a rich woman. But she need people actually to take care of her business that always steal is not fair. They told about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's sadiq. He's a truthful one. And let me test him. And she make him and her servant, his Maysara, Maysara, go with my business all the way to Sham, Palestine area, to Palestine area. Actually, in Akka now under occupation, you know, actually West Bank area. And then when they went there, Maysara watch the servant of Khadija watching Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he, subhanAllah, guided him. Even normally, they give the business, and when they come back, they take money and go back to Mecca. But this time, no. When everybody have sold all the business, he replaced the business to another business to Mecca. He got the money over there, and he bought business, and he sold it, so the money become double. And he gave Khadija everything. And who's watching? Maysara, the servant. When saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he really truthful person who will take care of the business, give attention. She performed marriage. He went to marry him. She went to marry Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's not shame, by the way. If your daughter, I wish I would translate it. If your daughter went to get married, don't say, oh, no. You, somebody has to propose for you. No problem for the sister to yes, I like Taimur. Not me, because I'm not gay. So I want to marry him. So no problem with your sister, your daughter, to say, I want to marry so and so, if he's truthful. Imagine, not only that, 15 years different. 15 سنة. But who against Khadija, her father? his father against for him to marry her. Now, why? Because he's an orphan. هو يتيم. اليتيم لا ما يتزوج. But because number one, he's truthful and she's in love with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. We have to. Everybody loves Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Right? And she gathered everybody there and she gave everybody what? Include her father, liquor to drink, to drink, to drink. And then after they are already very high, ask her father, I want to marry him. Oh, marry him. And they marry Khadija رضي الله عنها. She marry Rasulullah Khadija رضي الله عنها. And هي أرد زوجته الصالحة. My point, brother, Khadija رضي الله عنها, if I speak about Khadija, we're not going to finish. Especially when, inshallah, maybe tomorrow or next week, when Khadija رضي الله عنها become, she gave everything to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he have daughters, and the sons, they die. The sons, they die. But all his daughters with from Khadija, and all his kids become Muslim. The first one, even Khadija herself. But the key, when Allah, and then when Rasulullah suddenly become 53 years old, now he felt he want to go, يتعبد. He go to the mountain, and he wonder what's going on. He wonder until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the message. Jibreel alayhi salam came to Rasulullah. He saw a man came suddenly from nowhere and what he said to him, اقرأ. قال ما أنا بقارئ. Read. I cannot read. You cannot read. You cannot write. You cannot read. And he squeezed him. ضغط حتى لا يكفيد اقرأ قال ما أنا بقارئ ثلاث مرات three times اقرأ read I'm unable to read unable to read then اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم القلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم خمس آيات جميع الدين شرب فور وفنش إن شاء الله ماذا قال له what he said to him اقرأ باسم ربك الذي علم اقرأ اقرأ is very important brother القراءة To read is more important than online, by the way. Sometimes online we get some benefits. But al-kutub, al-ahadith, al-sira, al-kutub, to read the book more than anything. Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala, rahmatullah wasi'a, when he put him in the prison, Syrian prison, until now they do the same thing, قال كتابي جنتي. My book is my Jannah. My book is my Jannah, supposed to be. I wish actually our kids also to be reading more than anything else in our life. Anything else. And in knowledge, read. Our heart and our brain will be more expand, more understanding, more than in online. But anyway, in the summary, of course, brother and sister, You know, to speak about Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is more and more profound. But my point, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم lived on those years until the message, the hardship and calamity become more and more, especially with his own family. But the most important thing, he do this for me, for you, for us, and that for all mankind. That's why. When we say yesterday and today, actually, in purpose, actually, to recite those ayat, today, the last ayah, I repeat it again, وَمَنْ يُطِعَ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهَ Whoever obey Rasulullah, Rasulullah, صلى الله عليه وسلم, يعني you, أنت تطيع الله عز وجل. Think about it. Alhamdulillah, our masjid, we do that. We love to have more and more and more. I wish I could speak more and more the time and running fast, especially to be the seerah of Rasulullah. And I wish actually, alhamdulillah, I see our kids here. May Allah bless you all and the fathers. You know, to understand the seerah of our kids is very important. Very, very important, especially the sahaba of Rasulullah. By the way, Allah khtar hawla'i sahaba li Rasulullah. Allah had to choose those sahaba, the companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imagine. Badr, the last battle, is a few numbers. Sahaba with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but the Islam came where? All Pakistan, Russia, here, America, all over the world. With a small number came to the whole entire world. That's Sahaba. That's why we speak about the Sahaba more when we finish. And we're supposed to love the Sahaba. Sometimes I know people give new names for their sons and daughters. I feel sometimes shy to understand. Let me ask a question. I ask the kids that no one of the kids even raised their hands. I say, man huwa al-Qa'qa' ibn Amr al-Tamimi? And even my, my wife actually. Say, inshallah, when you have a son, I will call him Qaqa, Al-Qaqa. I say, Ibrahim, are you crazy? Why? Because the Qaqa, the people go to Kaka or something like this. True, the people, because if the, who is the Qaqa ibn Amr, the warrior with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that you'll be proud to know who is the Qaqa. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me the Jannah, number one, before Khalid, I want to see Qaqa ibn Amr al-Tamimi, inshallah. سبحانك الله وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب أسأل الله العظيم رب العالمين أن يجمعنا جميعا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم gather all of us with رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في جنة الخلد في جنة النعيم على سر المتقابلين آمين آمين يا رب. I don't know if you have any question or we we'll continue إن شاء الله next week إن شاء الله دكتور كمال gonna be about a very important topic very important topic that topic is again The unseen killer for next week بإذن الله جزاكم الله خير السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
My phone ran out of storage this time this week.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm gonna delete some stuff today, and then.
جزاك الله خير.